IPOB one family. IPOB one family. One family. Honorable Wale Agbadoso. Sweet. If you never know her, Chame, you go know her. Honorable Wale Agbadoso. We must continue. We must keep moving. Okay, this is your brother, your boy Ufuma Biafra and Saint Mazi Unamdi Kanu is my leader. Ego. God is my father. He's my leader. Hey, my father. Your son loyal. A lawyer so that feel royal. Okay, he's the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, and Ushemifo is my deputy leader. They are doing wonderfully well, wonderfully well. Can. How many times I've called him? Person the shame on. Person the shame. Person the shame. Now, I remember in those days, even before now, that should be last year now, I was doing video, talking to the church. Based on where I still stay, telling the church that this Islamization agenda is so real. Our leader has been saying it. Mass Unamdekan has been saying it. All Biafran activists, IPOB, we have been saying, we have been crying that the church should wake up. But you people call us name. You call us Antichrist. Somebody even wrote me, Fuma, so you don't join Antichrist. So you don't join people when we say they castigate the body of Christ. Because they will turn the everything upside down. When you are trying to fight for them, they will, in fact, they will present you. In fact, oh God, they said they serve the Antichrist. But today, the same Antichrist, when we saw that call us, on another right to go meet US and Israel. Now, after the killing of the Khan Shema, by Boko Haram, Ona Kashema, they write later, they go meet Israel and America, say, may they call help us, help Christians, help you guys to do what? Ona no fi pray again. Ona no fi pray. Ona supposed to be pray by now. Ona supposed to be trade religion by now. When they are telling you guys serious thing, that is when you be attacking us. We have been telling you people that they are prepared to Islamize you guys. But you say, no, IPOB, nobody can Islamize Nigeria, nobody can Islamize we Christians. Well, if they feel kidnap the Khan Shema, now we say, you will be honorary Christian, you're under finish. You now under finish. Khan President, you don't need to write to Israel and America to come and help you. You are supposed to go down on your knees now, presently. You see why I'm telling you people that you are too religious. You play politics in everything you do. You just play politics. You are writing to Israel to come and help you. The same Israel that is supporting Biafra. You are writing to America that America should come and help you. The same America that is fighting corruption, that is fighting to make South Africa free from colonial masters. You are writing them to do what? To fight with you with the God that you are condemning. Okay, if Israel won't follow, well, if Israel won't help on a fight, how Israel won't help on a fight? Not be the same God one at all say, that's anarchy. When I call quote scripture, that's anarchy. Not be the same God. That is to say, if Israel come and come follow you fight, they carry gun, keep us, that you keep you. That is to say, we could still carry gun, defend ourselves too. Even Jesus Christ talking, he said, now is the time. Go and sell anything you have and buy sword. You're not tossing a Bible. If they talk about Bible, you say Bible, the word, you will say sword. Because the time, this is the time. This is the time the church needs to wake up. Instead of the church to wake up, to come together on a day that they play, on a day that they come, they fight us. Now they fight us. Now let me tell Khan what to do. Let me tell the church what to do. Since you don't need to call Israel, you don't need to call America to come and fight for you. Let me tell you guys what you need to do presently. Tell all Christians to support IPOB, to support Biafra. Biafra represents freedom. Biafra marks the end of Fulani killing, the end of Boko Haram. Biafra, The coming of Biafra will stop all this nonsense. I assure you, the coming of Biafra will stop all this nonsense. And Nigeria will disintegrate before your eyes. Can President write to all Christians, write to all bishops, to all pastors, to every church in the zoo called Nigeria, that they should wake up and support IPOB, that they should support this man, who my leader Bishop Emile Isina. Can, you don't need to write to Israel and America. The only person that the zoo is afraid of, the only person that the zoo government, Nigerian government is afraid of, is this man, St. Manzi Nnamdi Kanu. If they see and they shiver, but you see this man Nnamdi Kanu is here for you. Just write him a letter, because on our don't shine on a letter now they go even the wrong side. The real person on a support letter go meet maybe this Nnamdi Kanu. He's fighting for Christians. He's fighting for every. If in fact, as far you are a black man, he's fighting for you. So don't write letter, don't send letter to Israel and America. Send letter to IPOB and make public announcement to all Christians that they should support Biafra, that they should follow the step of IPOB. They should all become IPOB members. I assure you, then your freedom, the killing of Christians will stop in Biafra. I assure you, IPOB one family. So I'm advising the body of Christ, I'm advising the Christians in particular, that now is the time to awake from your nightmare, from your sleep, from your dream, because we are facing the reality. If you continue, if the church or if the church in the zoo continue in this manner, you remember, everybody know this thing, you remember what happened to Turkey? You know Turkey was once a Christian country. You know, when Jesus Christ appeared to John, beloved, in the Isle of Patmos, you know, Jesus, the seven churches that Jesus Christ said to John that they should send the letter to, they were in Turkey. I know their works, the church of Laodicea. I know their works, the church of Ephesus. I know their works, the church of Philadelphia. I know their works, the church of Thyatira. All in Turkey. But because of the politics and their religious lifestyle, Islam uprooted Christianity from Turkey. That is what is now happening to the Christians in Nigeria. So, but we are not going to allow it. That is why we are using a platform of freedom and, you know, IPOB to make sure we fight for our freedom. And our freedom will surely come. And Christianity cannot be uprooted from Nigeria. IPOB want family. So the church should wake up and support the freedom of Biafra. The freedom of Biafra is the freedom of everybody. If not, the time is coming, you will change your name to Ibrahim Abubakar Mustafa as a Christian. I assure you, if you don't wake up and fight for your right now, I pity you. God will be folding his hand to wash you guys. You think God loves you more than the way he loves the Christians in Turkey? When God promised Moses, I am giving you a land flowing with milk and honey, God not tell Moses, say, go keep people to take collect their land. God did not promise Moses that Moses, the land flowing with milk and honey, and the land of Jebusite, Amorite, Hittite, Anit, Ayat, all the Ites. God not greet them. Now, after they don't come out from Egypt, now God tell Moses, say, Moses, mona go sharp on a sword. Mona need to go kill the Jebusite. Mona collect their land. You don't understand. God will be folding his hand to wash you, how you play your role. He has given you the dominion. So it is left for you to take it by force. It is left for you to take it by force. God bless Manzi Nnamdi Kanu, the great leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. And God bless Biafran freedom fighters all over the world. Lastly, God bless the United States of Biafra. My name is Ufuma Ushasi. Some other time. Thank you.